Hi everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. We're going to be doing another integration by parts problem today. This one is the integral of x to the 7th times ln, or the natural log of x, dx. So we're going to be using the integration by parts formula, which, if you'll remember, is I'm just going to write the second half, uv minus the integral of v du. And what we do is assign u and dv to each term in our problem here. So the first thing we need to do is pick which one of the components of our integral will be u and which one will be dv. And we always, for integration by parts, try to pick whichever one for u will simplify itself when we take the derivative, which in this case is a pretty natural giveaway, because ln, or the natural log of x, when we take the derivative of that, we get 1 over x, which is much simpler than natural log of x. So ln of x here ends up being a good candidate to assign u to. So we'll say that u equals natural log of x, and then we'll take the derivative of that and get 1 over x. Because we assigned ln of x to u, that means that dv must be x to the 7th. So we'll say dv equals x to the 7th, and then v, we add 1 to the exponent, because here we're taking the integral to get v. We add 1 to the exponent to get 8, and then we divide the coefficient, which is an implied 1, by the new exponent, which is 8. Now that we've calculated u, du, v, and dv, we can go ahead and plug them into our integration by parts equation here. So you can see we have u times v. So let's go ahead and write this out here. We have ln of x times v, which is 1/8 x to the 8th, minus the integral of v du. So we have 1/8 x to the 8th times du, which is 1 over x. And then we have to, of course, add dx here, because it accompanies the integral as part of integral notation. So now that we've done that, we can go ahead and simplify somewhat. So I'm going to bring 1/8 out in front here as the coefficient. I'm also going to bring out the x to the 8th, because that should go in front of the natural log of x. So we'll have 1/8 x to the 8th ln of x minus, and then here for the integral, we can bring 1/8 out in front of the integral, because it's a coefficient and everything inside is multiplied together. So we'll bring that out in front, and we'll be left with the integral of x to the 8th over x, which, because we have, right, 8 x's in the numerator and 1 in the denominator, that will simplify to x to the 7th. So x to the 7th dx. Now this is something that we can easily take the integral of, so we'll go ahead and do that. We'll end up with 1/8 x to the 8th ln of x minus 1/8, and then I'll draw a big parenthesis to denote that this is clearly where we're starting to write down what we got when we took this integral. So again, with x to the 7th, we add 1 to the exponent and then divide the coefficient 1 by the new exponent, which is of course going to be 8. It's 1/8 x to the 8th, and then we add c to account for the constant. And now all we have to do, let's go ahead and erase this part, is just simplify. What I'm going to do is go ahead and factor out 1/8 x to the 8th, because I think that'll be the cleanest answer. So I'll factor out 1/8 x to the 8th, and then I will multiply that by ln of x in the first term here. And then all we have left in the second term is 1/8, so it'll just be minus 1/8 plus c. And that is our final answer. So hope that helped, and I will see you guys next time. Bye!